Okay, so you've decided to study mathematics. You've set up a good study system. You've done a wonderful thing. You're determined. But you sit down to study mathematics. You're sitting there at the desk. What then? Well, the simple answer is you're going to be doing one of four things. Two of them are taught quite well at school, and two aren't taught so well. Stay tuned, and I'll tell you what they are. G'day, and welcome to Crystal Clear Mathematics, where it is easier than you think. I'm your host, Graham Henderson. I'm going to be sharing with you the four different ways of studying mathematics, and I'll be devoting one video to each method. The first two are going to be the ones that are commonly taught in schools, and the last two are going to be the less common ones. The first study method is used when you want to memorize facts. This is information. In mathematics, there are things like formulae, definitions, descriptions, names of objects, and correct spellings. It's a good idea to keep a folder or a booklet precisely for this purpose. When you decide to study a particular topic, tonight for example, sit down, open your textbook and your workbook to the relevant chapter or topic, get a clean sheet of paper, and start writing. As you go page by page through your textbook, try to identify anything that you feel you should remember by way of a fact or a definition or a formula that you aren't confident of remembering for 6 or 12 months at least. So if there's any doubt in your mind that you don't know it well enough, write it down. Now put your textbook aside and spend some time rewriting the material and putting it in some order and structure that makes sense to you. Be very careful with this. Take your time. Be careful to spell things correctly because correct spelling really enhances communication. When your summary sheet is complete, put it aside face down and take a new sheet and try to recreate that entire summary from memory while it's fresh in your mind. Now, of course, it's highly unlikely you'll remember it exactly. But that's okay. When you're finished, take your summary sheet and compare the two. Now, at this stage, you've got a choice of two things. If you're running short on time, you can use your diary to make a note to try this again the next night or a little later in the week. But if you do have time, you might try to complete this activity two or three or four times over. Your goal is twofold. First, you want to learn the material, and that requires a lot of practice over a very short period of time, say over 3 or 4 days. And the second thing you want is to have it stored properly in your long-term memory so that you can recall it whenever you wish. And that requires the use of a diary so that you can rehearse and practice this at properly spaced intervals over a long period of time until you're satisfied that you can remember it for 6 to 12 months at least. Some sheets, for example, one requiring you to memorize the parts of a circle, your revision may only require 2 or 3 or 4 minutes per training session. In the case of more complicated sheets requiring definitions or quotations to be memorized, you may spend up to 15 minutes or so per sheet per training session. So this is a significant time investment, but it does pay off. In time, I'd recommend that you make summaries of your summaries, that is, summaries of your summary sheet, and eliminate the things that you're now very confident that you've remembered and learned properly. And as your summary reduces in size, the exercise takes less and less time. And periodically, every few months, you might go back to your original summary and make sure that you have remembered and recalled everything that was on it. How do you memorize sheets, apart from writing them out over and over again, which is, by the way, a good method? There are numerous ways to enhance your memorizing skills. Some people like to use as many of their senses as they possibly can. They like to read them out aloud so that they're using their voice and hearing, their sight. Some people like to walk around the room or even run around the block while they're listening to summaries, or even in some cases singing them out loud or reciting them, a bit like chanting that I see in some American military movies. Some people use their sense of rhythm by putting their summaries into rhyme and putting them to music, creating songs, rap, poetry, and find that of immense value. Many people benefit from using mnemonics, which are memory aids. A very popular form of memory aid is an acronym, where the first letter of each word is used to create a new word or saying or sound that makes sense. One that you might be familiar with if you are used to expanding binomial products is the word FOIL, meaning first, outside, inside, last. Those of you who've learned trigonometry will no doubt know SOHCAHTOA, which describes the three basic trigonometric ratios. Try to make up clever acronyms for other aspects of your mathematics. There are many good videos on YouTube describing how to use memory pegs or memory keys to remember lists. Experiment with a variety of memory techniques and search for them on the internet. You might find some quite humorous and clever and enjoyable ones that help you remember your information very efficiently. The whole idea is for you to discover what works for you. So, now you should have a summary book or a summary folder in place and know how to use it to keep summaries of your mathematical topics. In my next video, I'll be explaining how to learn things that you do, that is, mathematical skills. This is Graham Henderson, hoping that with practice and creative help, you'll be able to create and manage and learn your own summaries. Now, of course, I'll be attempting to post a variety of summaries of mathematical topics on my website, but you need to know that you'll learn your own summaries far better. Please subscribe to this channel or like or comment on this video. Thank you.